$10.
Only $10?
So that's what you were doing in the toy store.
I've got it all figured out. So that's why I think if you buy me moon boots, it would be good for the whole family.
Well, Arthur, we just bought you new sneakers.
Dad, moon boots would actually prolong the life of my sneakers.
And what about your beautiful new coat?
And I'll let you and Dad use them whenever you want.
Well, I don't know about that, but if you want moon boots, you'll have to buy them with your own money.
That way you'll appreciate them more.
Like the way you appreciate me.
I owe myself $4.30. Sincerely, Arthur.
Where that went. Aha!
Hi, Grandma. Look what I brought.
Arthur, they're lovely. Now, you're not here about your moon boots, are you? Because your parents already called me.
They did?
Yes, and they told me not to give you any money, and I have to respect their wishes. While you're here, though, why don't we sit down and we'll play a nice long game of canasta?
King me!
DW, I told you. You have to get to my back row to be kinged.
I know, I just like saying it.
My calculations may be off, but I figured at the rate I'm going, by the time I save up enough money for the moon boots, I'll be 109 years old.
You know, Arthur, there are plenty of ways you can earn money right around here.
King me.
Lemonade! Arthur's ice cold lemonade! Come in! Hey! Hey, you! Get back here! Bring that back!
Kissing booth? Ew!
Come find out your future. I am gifted with the rare power to see into the future. Boy, by the time I get enough money to buy moon boots, people will actually be living on the moon.
Aw.
Why couldn't you have done that when I had the kissing booth?
You know, Arthur, I still have some of my birthday money left.
You do?
Yes, and I could lend you some if you wanted.
Really?
Of course, if I loan you the money, you have to agree to be my servant and do all my chores and call me Your Highness for a whole year.
Fat chance, and I take my hug back.
Okay, but remember, it's a limited time offer.
Regular boots? Move!